My name is Jane Ni Dhulchaointigh and I'm the inventor of Sugru. So Sugru is a new material. It starts off a bit like plasticine or Play-Doh. You can mould it into any shape and it comes in loads of colours. But the magic part is that by exposing it just to the atmospheric, just to the air, it will transform overnight into a really durable and flexible silicone rubber like this. And I invented it to basically make making things, modifying things, mending things easy and fun for anybody. It's a combination of some top secret ingredients, but basically a silicone polymer with some very kind of special fillers that have a really particular set of characteristics which allow us to put lots of filler into Sugru to give it those tactile properties, but also allow it to cure into a really tough and durable silicone rubber. The development process for Sugru was long, and the first version that we had is completely different from what Sugru is today. I mean, the first prototype that I made with Sugru was so smelly and sticky, honestly, like you couldn't hardly be in the room with it, it was horrible. The most important skills that I developed was to have patience. You know, like new materials don't get invented overnight. The other thing is, I think, observation skills. When you're developing something like Sugru, which is by combining different types of ingredients that haven't been combined before, you need to be very observant as to what's happening and very, very disciplined about only changing one thing at a time. So the experimental process is very, very important to be strict. So it's really important with any product, and especially something like Sugru that you're relying on to do a job, that every single pack of Sugru is exactly the same. So we have to test that really rigorously, and we test it for its before cure properties, so it's actually like always the same kind of plasticity, and then we test it for its cured properties, and that's basically its strength and its adhesion. And to test the strength, we use a tensile testing machine which pulls it slowly apart and tests how strong it is and what point it breaks, and then to test the adhesion, we stick it to aluminium and different materials and do peel tests. Some of the things that people have done with Sugru are just pretty mind-blowing. So I've got a few examples here. So one is, for example, it needs to be really waterproof. So people use it to fix their hiking boots and shoes and stuff like that. It needs to be flexible. So you can see here, this is an idea that somebody in our community did with Sugru, and they just applied the Sugru onto a camera because they wanted their three-year-old to be able to take photographs and they didn't want the camera to break. People find it really helpful to be able to protect gadgets, so that's got like a kind of a bounce to it, so it sticks really well to glass and plastics that are in phones, plastics like games controllers. When it cures, it needs to be really waterproof, it needs to bond to almost any material, and it needs to be flexible and bouncy. We ended up launching through our own website online and getting like lots of people excited about it on the internet. And so that basically showed us that we were able to scale up, and we were able to raise the funding then to build a factory, which we have here in East London now. My dream for Sugru is the same today that it always has been. It is all about making, mending and making stuff easy for anyone. And I really think that Sugru is so useful and so easy to use as well, that I think it has a chance to be in everyone's kitchen drawer in about 10 years' time.